one can tell.
Welcome aboard the good ship Lollipop. Away we go. We got a fun episode today, everybody. Go, go. There we go. Good job. These dogs really need to get out. I heard somewhere that dogs expend a lot of energy sniffing stuff. So I can't really, come on. Hurry. And knowing the drivers are in this area, I don't want to get anywhere near the roads. Here to talk about film recipes. These are classic film types, film styles, made by real film manufacturers that we're gonna plagiarize the shit out of, at least the look of it, and perhaps the spirit of it as well. We're talking about Fujifilm recipes. These are digital files in the Fuji cameras. They're a facsimile, similar, reproduction, fake and bake, liar, liar, pants on fire. I don't see it that way. I see it as a tribute, a bringing back of film types and bringing it back into modern day, digital day. People still shoot film and that's an art form. And I have full respect over film shooters. I think it's an incredible process of development for photography. I think it's hard to beat.
I'm the great pretender.
The years of dedication applied to an analog film and the development and the camera techniques that they used to create the impossible over 100 years. And all of these different film types and film styles used by these different artists created looks. Very definite, distinguishable looks. That's why they chose different film processes, different color techniques, different types of film, shooting conditions, filters. They used whatever they could use to get the look that they wanted to get.
I seem to be what I'm not.
You see,
I'm wearing my heart like a crown. Pretend that you're still around.
Now we're on to a digital age where the smart thing to do really is to shoot raw. Big fat file has a lot of room for changing it, editing it, cleaning it up, whatever. Chosen 7 film recipes. Got them all from Fuji X Weekly. Fuji X Weekly is kind of the hub for Fuji recipes. I find all my favorite recipes on there. Thanks Fuji X Weekly. It's really nice to have some of this centralized and accessible for everyone, and also nice to still have the artist name on it and representing it. Well, these film recipes are based off of film simulations built into the Fuji camera, going up and down. Each one of them is very subtle, but when you combine them and you start contradicting them and then you start creating different white balances, it's like a digital chemistry, really. And I love how Fuji has that set up.
I'm the great pretender. Just laughing and gay like a clown. I seem to
because there's no doubt raw gives you more control, it's safer, and if you have the look you like and have figured that out, raw is perfect because it really enables the photographer to put forth the best that they shot. I do it a little different than that, and I don't have any no harm, no foul on anybody. It's just how my workflow works and how I prefer to do it. Really, and I've shot raw, an old Photoshop whiz back from Photoshop 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And now with the new Fuji system and the way they do their JPEGs, I've just fallen in love with it. Well, there's a lot of reasons. The main one is this. You approach a scene, you have a time and a place. And that time and place has a mood. That time and place has a vibe. That time and place has a presence. With a raw photo, if you're the type that has the ability to shoot and edit with that intention, then you got the gold mine, really. You got the mother lode. I'm not that organized. I can't do that. What the JPEGs make it possible for me to do is to, within my camera, work in how I want to shoot it, what type of film I want to use. It's not as if it's a locked in formula. I've got options within every recipe that I use, just a tap of the quick menu, and I can adjust anything. That time, place, light, the light study, and with a mirrorless camera, you know, what you see is what you get. What you see before the shot is exactly what you're gonna see after it.
I'm wearing my heart like a crown, pretend that you're
So, looking through the Fuji camera, looking through the film recipes, I get a really tight preview of what's going to happen. That time and place becomes really essential because, you know, what you're going to do right then, what you're going to do right now, you know, how the Great Pretenders, the Fuji X-Pro3, and the Great Pretender recipes. Even though we're pretending here, it's in honor of, it's in tribute to. This isn't anti-editing, and it isn't pre-editing. It's time, place, recipe. We're using it live. We're using it as this recipe sees the light. And so with that feedback, it really gives you a lot of options. In tribute to these awesome films and keeping the look alive. The home run of this whole thing. You get it out of the camera without having to do anything. No straightening, no cropping, no brightening, no highlights, no shadows. It's really fun within the Fuji camera when you get it. You connect it. It doesn't happen all the time, but you know, the more you practice it, the more that feeling comes around. And if that's not a film type attitude or a film behavior, then what is? It's the spirit of the thing. It's the science. It's the fact that we're doing science digitally to reproduce what's already been done, because what's already been done is brilliant. Anyways, really love this movement. There's a lot of photographers out there shooting this way. Kind of movement is happening, and really enjoy the people who support it and like it. It's not the only way. It's not the right way. It's just the way we do it. That's all. It's fun. Working at color within your camera. It's important to me. And thanks for coming to my channel.